Hi, and tonight I hope everyone's well, and I'm going to talk about skincare in your 40s and what you need to be thinking about now that you're in your 40s. What you need to be knowing is it's the usual thing that's happening in the 40s. The rate of your skin renewal has slowed down. So when you're a teenager, it was like running really quickly, and then in your 20s it was, you know, really still quite good. In your 30s, it's like a jog, a nice fast jog. And now we're in a slow jog now that we're in our 40s. And I mean by that because the epidermis, the outer layer of your skin, by the time the cells come from the basal layer, the bottom of it, up to the top, it's slowed down. So the skin renewal system, because it's slowed down, dead skin cells don't come off. You don't shed your dead skin just as well as you should. And because of that, lines and wrinkles become set and more noticeable, and your collagen is starting to deplete in your skin. So I suppose that's the one word I want you to remember. What we've got to be thinking about is stimulating and focusing on that collagen. Let's get that collagen working, these two proteins, collagen and elastin, to plump the skin up so the skin looks fuller and fresher and younger again. Okay, so we're going to focus on the collagen in your 40s. So how are we going to treat the rest of the skin? How are we thinking about this? You know, in your 40s, you're losing your moisture, your own natural oils as well. Your skin is starting to become drier, usually. So what we need to be thinking of is, if you wear makeup, I want you to be thinking of using a nice calming face and eye makeup remover to take the makeup off. So cleansing is really important in your 40s, even more so because we want to make sure we don't want to leave any chemicals, bad chemicals on the skin that makeup sometimes has. The agents in makeup, we don't want to be leaving that on the skin. So makeup remover, this is a time to really invest in your skincare. So you take all the makeup off gently, okay? And then the next thing is the cleansing. Cleansing is now, you know, you've got to be thinking about the right cleansers. So I don't want you to think about cleansers that strip your skin. So even if you've got acne flare-ups, still getting those, not good. Or if you've got an oily, you feel you've got an oily combination type skin, I do not want you stripping your oils out. So we've got to keep our own natural moisturisers high in our skin. Okay, so you're thinking about a cleanser that's got glycolic acid in it. That's a great way to start. A glycolic acid is going to speed up that cell renewal and stimulate the collagen. Wow, so that's what we need to be thinking about, using glycolic acid in your skincare regime somewhere in it, but a cleanser would be great. Also, I still like this idea, when you put your cleanser on, it should feel, when you apply your cleanser on, it shouldn't sting your face. You should be feeling it's cleansing really, really nicely. It should feel calming on the skin, okay? But I do like, if you've got normal to combination oily skin, I still like this face cloth idea, rinsing it out in lukewarm water and taking the cleanser off with that. Always remember, we need to try to speed up the cell renewal and getting the skin, this dead skin cells shed off. So the face cloth acts as an exfoliator, but always lukewarm water. You've got to be thinking about not having any inflammation on your skin, right? No pinkness. Try to really reduce inflammation. So looking at definitely antioxidants in your skincare, antioxidant rich, but in the cleanser, cleanse thoroughly is your next step. Now, I hope and pray all you guys out there, all you 40-year-olds out there, are all using eye cream religiously. So the thing about eye cream is, you need to be thinking about eye cream, especially if you're not a good sleeper or you're prone to puffiness. But generally, keeping this area here moisturised is going to keep the lines softer looking. And you have to be thinking about that. Also, using products, eye creams with caffeine in them, is going to stimulate the microcirculation here, so it's going to help drain the eye, reduce the puffiness, reduce any pigmentation you've got. So caffeine is a great thing to have in your eye cream, but eye creams, putting on AM and PM, just a split pea size, not overdoing it, but do not forget to put the eye cream on morning and night. So eye cream, religious about that. So after the eye cream, I'd be thinking about, okay, what can we use that's going to stimulate collagen renewal, is going to plump the skin back up. And this is where it's all about the serums. It's all about the serums. You need to be using really good serums now, okay? So this is it. Get the serum into the serum habit. And you're putting on a serum at night. Now, a good one to use at night, if you can think about it, please, is retinol, a form of vitamin A. When you put that onto the skin at night, that is definitely going to stimulate skin cell renewal. It's going to help shed the skin off quicker and make your skin healthier and fresher. It will. So it's a huge, powerful antioxidant, vitamin A. Mm-hmm. And putting that on at night in your 40s, you're going to thank me when you're 50. You are. So that is really crucial. Vitamin A at night is a good one to start getting into the habit of, and getting one that you like, okay? So if you weren't thinking about vitamin A, I would think that, you know, the growth factors, these are the new peptides that are out. I think using a peptide, you remember, the peptides are the clever guys, the cell communicating, they tell the skin cells how to behave, how to be healthy, how to normalize the skin. So, and they also, you know, there's great, a number of peptides out there that stimulate collagen. And I've told you, I need you to go hardcore on that collagen. Hi, Lorraine. So hardcore on the collagen. So cell communicating peptides, collagen peptides, that's how you need to be thinking of. So serums are ultra important now you're in your 40s. And I told you vitamin C, vitamin A at night, but a good one to think about in the daytime is vitamin C. So you've cleansed your skin in the morning. You've taken off any debris that's occurred overnight, but the vitamin C during the day is crucial, because this vitamin C stands for collagen. If I could get you to just remember that little thing. So vitamin C stimulates elastin to make collagen. Mm-hmm. Even getting vitamin C into your foods, all of that. And you are what you eat. Remember, you are what you eat, you are what you eat. So vitamin C enriched foods. So vitamin C during the day, vitamin A at night, that's a real massive wow, a double whammy to the skin. And you can then add in your growth factors, your cell communicating peptides, collagen stimulating peptides. That's how you need to be thinking. So that's the serum talk. The next talk I want you to think about is the moisturiser. So remember, hyaluronic acid is a favourite moisturising agent of mine because it holds 1,000 times its own weight in water. Right? I know you're going to remember all these things, but hyaluronic acid, and I want you to think about moisturisers, putting that on. Hyaluronic is going to draw moisture from the air, so it's really great if you've got that dehydrated skin. Mm-hmm. You work in a dry area, that's going to be fabulous for you. And also, I need you to think about moisturisers as they seal the serums into the skin. So a moisturiser, putting that on top, always ensuring that you let the serum absorb. So the eye cream is going to absorb, the serum is going to absorb. Never forget about the décolleté, okay? And then you're putting the moisturiser, once that's all absorbed, moisturiser on top is going to seal the serums in, right? And finally, you know, I'm going to nag this about for the rest of my time, is the most important thing about your 40s is to stop the big yellow guy from breaking your collagen up, okay? Now, don't forget that the big yellow guy in the sky that's been about this summer, right? He breaks up collagen fibres, and that causes you to get saggy. When you get older, saggy and wrinkled. So you have to, after the moisturiser's on, you have to put on the sunscreen. It's a must, it's a must. So if you do those things, they're going to really keep your collagen strong, keep your skin and face as plump as possible, right? Giving it hyaluronic acid as well is going to keep supporting the collagen fibres. You lose your hyaluronic acid, which you produce yourself, that's going to help keep the skin looking healthy. right? So I hope you've got it. That's what happens and what you should be focused on. Go hardcore of collagen fixing stuff in your 40s. So remember, if you have any skincare questions, you can put them in the comments below and I'll try and answer them. And if you get any problems that you want to chat about, you can email me, joan@jlformulations.com, and I can help you there. If you need a skin expert, we've got all these JL girls out there ready to look after you, and just email me and we will give you the nearest salon to you. So have a great week, everybody. Take care and hope that's given you some information. Next week, I'm going to cover the 50s. Oh, that will be a good one. So take care. Love to see you. Bye.